이번 목적지는 졸업생들에게 The Gold Commitment, 즉 황금의 약속을 해주는 대학인데요. 바로 드포 대학교입니다. 개신교 감리교단의 지원으로 1837년 인디애나주 중부에 설립된 드포 대학교는 US News and World Report가 집계한 2020년 미국 리버럴 아츠 대학 순위 46위에 올라 있습니다. 우수한 교수진과 교수 한 명당 학생 8명의 적절한 비율, 아너 장학금 프로그램 등을 통해 변화를 주도하는 리더를 양성하고 있는데요. 또한 매년 갓 입학한 신입생에게 멘토 그룹을 배정해 주어 1년 동안 적응을 돕는 독특한 제도가 있다고 합니다. 1학년 등록 유지 비율이 92%인 걸 보면 확실히 효과가 있는 것 같네요. 드포 대학교의 학생들을 위한 골드 커미트먼트, 즉 황금의 약속이란 과연 무엇인지 얼른 알아보고 싶은데요. 함께 가볼까요? 저는 미스 코리아 USA 수상자이자 최근에 경영 대학을 졸업한 조민희입니다. 함께 미국 인류 대학들을 탐방하며 더 깊은 이야기를 들어보고 이 위대한 나라 형성에 어떻게 기여했는지 알아볼 텐데요. 준비되셨나요? 그럼 출발합니다. 드포 대학교는 인디애나주 그린캐슬이라는 작은 도시에 있습니다. 리버럴 아츠 대학인 이곳의 이념은 리버럴 아츠에 대한 비범한 열정으로 세상에 필요한 리더를 양성하는 것이죠. 드포 대학교의 리버럴 아츠에 대한 열정은 학생에 대한 특별한 열정으로 나타난다고 하는데요. 더 알아보기 위해 데이브 버크 씨와 이야기를 나눴습니다. 드포 대학교의 많은 사람처럼 데이브 씨도 여러 면모를 지녔습니다. 학생처 부총장이면서 컴퓨터 공학 교수기도 하죠.
What is the gold commitment?
So the gold commitment is DePauw's commitment to every single student's success. We say that DePauw people are gold within. They have a way of thinking about themselves as being very valuable and helping to find value in others and in the work that they do. So our gold standard commitment to our students is that if students come to DePauw and fully engage us in the classroom, then we are committed to making sure that those students are successful after they graduate. And if after 6 months from graduating from DePauw, a student doesn't have a job or isn't in graduate school, we're committed to letting them come back to DePauw for a semester, tuition free, or we will commit to finding them a 6-month starter job, sort of like a long internship after graduation, to help them boost their resumes so they can then go out and find a more permanent job. So if students come to DePauw and commit to us fully, we commit back to them that they will be successful, guaranteed, after they graduate.
이 Gold Commitment은 미국 학생뿐 아니라 유학생에게도 적용됩니다. 더 알아보기 위해 유학처장 루트 피 지라리 씨와 이야기를 나눴습니다.
I think we are the only university in the US that has a guarantee. Students can come here to DePauw and regardless of the major that they study, they can do anything that they want. I really believe that that should be one of the principles of each university, ensuring that, you know, they have jobs, that they have a good, solid professional experience. Really, the sky is the limit for our students.
I hear that the school's mission is to develop leaders through an uncommon commitment to liberal arts. What's so uncommon about the approach that DePauw takes?
What's really uncommon about our approach to the liberal arts is that we combine traditional liberal arts instructions with hands-on experiential applied learning.
We are very, very proud of our liberal arts education roots. DePauw has been around since 1837, so a really long tradition of success, of commitment to students, of excellence, and also really a commitment to helping others.
You really prepare yourselves to step out into the world and to be a doer, rather than just an observer. And we think we have a really nice balance in our educational mission that prepares students to do just that.
That's the commitment that DePauw has, helping students achieve that success. We call it uncommon success. And that's really a model that I really enjoy whenever I talk to students and parents about what it means to join a university that provides uncommon success.
이런 비범한 성공은 DePauw 대학교 졸업생들이 기업을 경영하는 모습을 통해 확인할 수 있습니다. ESPN General Mills, 월트 디즈니사 등이 있죠. 그들은 또한 국가를 이끌고 사회 변혁을 위해 투쟁했습니다.
What excites you to be at DePauw?
Really, what brought me to the university is the commitments that they have to international education. It has always been a strong commitment to diversity within the U.S. and also outside the U.S. So one of our former presidents, President Bottom, he was a president during the 80s and early 90s. He was one of the champions for diversity.
What kind of community do you want to live in? I hope you want to be with diverse people. If you come to DePauw, you'll find people from all over the country, people from all economic backgrounds, and people from all different ethnic backgrounds. We value diversity. And we come to believe that you really can learn a lot by being in an environment where there are some people who are different.
Since his tenure, the emphasis that he had was making sure that DePauw really reflects the society within the U.S. and the global society. We've always focused on getting the best and brightest and making sure that we're helping students regardless of their social economical status. Diversity, socioeconomic differences, all those are very, very important aspects for DePauw.
Let's talk about the application process. What makes DePauw's application process unique?
We use holistic admission model, meaning that we really look at everything that the students submit to us, whether their grades, their SATs, but also, you know, the essay components, the recommendation letters. So we make sure that we review every application because we really want to understand the students. We want to make sure that they're going to be a good fit for us, but that we are also a good fit for them.
학생의 경험을 더 들어보기 위해 영화학 예비 4학년인 박민규 씨와 입학 과정에 관한 이야기를 나눴습니다.
3, 2, 1.
DePauw's application process is very simple, and it's actually the reason why I applied. One of my friends actually recommended it to me. She was like, oh, what about DePauw University? They have no application fees, no supplement essays, so all you have to do is, you know, just click and you're literally losing nothing. I cannot stress, in retrospect, how grateful I am that they made this application process so simple for me. And as of right now, DePauw is also a test optional school.
드포 대학교는 시험 선택권을 주는 대학 중 하나로 지원할 때 SAT나 ACT 시험 성적을 반드시 제출하지 않아도 됩니다.
So when we became test optional, really the reason for that was access, was ensuring that all the students, just because they don't have enough resources or because they cannot pay for tutoring, that they won't be able to join a good elite university. So really the students are first in everything that we try to do.
What's some advice that you would like to give to prospective students that would want to come to DePauw University?
Be open to everything. Try things that you've never tried before. You know, get out of your comfort zone. And I know it's insanely cliche to say that, but trust me, it works. Don't be afraid to talk to people because everyone at DePauw is so incredibly welcoming. Don't be afraid to ask for help because if there's anyone that can help you, it's at least one person at DePauw University.
Mingyo 씨는 영화 제작에 열정이 있지만 영화에 특화된 더 큰 학교에 가는 대신 DePauw 대학교를 선택했는데요. 이곳이 왜 민규 씨에게 알맞은 곳이었는지 더 들어보았습니다.
Film is a very specific study, but also the liberal arts education is very unique as well. When that comes together, what is that experience like?
being at a liberal arts college was crucial to my experience as a film student. Because we're not as large of an institution, we don't have those big names, we're not a film-focused school, we're a liberal arts college, mm-hmm. it's made me become more independent. I've had to navigate my own path and, you know, seek out more resources personally. And in doing so, I've been able to utilize the things that liberal arts college that larger institutions don't have, like personal connections with professors, with alumni, access to facilities and resources that would be really hard to get through when you're at a large institution. You know, it really gave me the opportunity to be an independent filmmaker. When I was doing my own short film, I was able to meet with my professor regularly. He would reach out to me to ask how it was going because he was also personally invested in my success. So we really get a chance to personalize our academic experience and work a lot with the people, the faculty, the staff. So that's probably the most exciting part about DePaul.
Freckles that start about half an inch below the eyes and the cheeks and...
Tell me more about your short film.
My first short film I made my second semester of my freshman year. It was called Reflection. It was a conceptual film about self-identity.
Small lips, sort of rosy pink.
Curly hair, tied back, but loosely.
And I was so determined because it was my first short film. I had never done filmmaking before. You know, I decided to become a film major when I came into college. I worked on it over fall break and I was emailing my professor and asking him about like which scene would work better where. I shot it in our art building called Peeler, and they have this beautiful painting studio with walls of glass that had beautiful lighting, so I used that. I was able to recruit some of my friends that I knew were interested in media, interested in filmmaking, to help me out with filming. I had friends that I'd met in an acting class that I asked to be the actors for my film. So yeah, it was very much a student-driven project that I got to work on.
And what is the academic rigor like for a film class?
I would say it's honestly pretty rigorous. With anything, in order to be well-versed in your field, you have to know a lot about it. And film has so many different angles, so many different aspects. There's a lot of academic reading. I took a film theory course, which was probably the hardest course, film course that I have ever taken. We learn a lot about, you know, film and culture, as well as how to write about film as well. So I think that also ties into the whole liberal arts aspect of the education. And I'm actually an English writing double major. And that's what I loved most about literature was, you know, learning all this academic language about literature, about English, and being able to apply that to my own interpretation and analysis of the piece. And I found that I could do the same with film. I think the value of a liberal arts education extends far beyond just the academic standpoint. Film is such a collaborative and it's such a creative and interactive field that it makes sense that it should be studied that way too, because, you know, it's not just one perspective, it's not just one answer to the piece, it's such a number of different factors. And when you have students that come from different backgrounds and different experiences and different professions, it's so important to have so many different outputs that can contribute to one discussion for a holistic understanding of the field.
이게 바로 리버럴 아츠 교육의 정수라고 할 수 있는데요. 자기 내면의 황금을 찾아낼 수 있게 다양한 각도로 세상을 경험하는 거죠. 이곳의 강의는 소규모라서 교수 한 명당 평균 학생의 수는 8명입니다. 드포대학교의 학업 문화는 전문 분야에 대한 흥미를 유발하고 학생과의 협업 기회를 창출하도록 설계되었죠.
So you've been a professor of computer science since the 90s. Tell me more about your work. What excites you about it?
I love computer science because it is all about problem solving and using technology to help people make their lives better in a variety of contexts. My specific area of interest in computer science is an area called human-computer interaction. And that area looks at how computers and humans interact with each other in ways that enhance human life and productivity.
It's very applicable to our lives today with the ever-changing world of technology. How does the university keep up with that?
We're very, very interested in not only the university keeping up with technology, but helping our students to keep up with technology and to improve their own technology skills and abilities. We have 8 special centers at DePauw, and one of those centers is called the Tensor Technology Center. And that's a place that students can go to take workshops about using technology tools if they're trying to incorporate technology into their classwork. And then also faculty can go there to learn about how they can incorporate technology into their classes. Right now, the Tensor Technology Center is really specialized in visualization. So that is using software tools to help people understand large data sets. And so that could be anything from financial data to data about sports or recreation. All kinds of data can be visualized in really interesting ways using the Tensor Technology Center.
Are you working on any exciting research right now?
We have a National Science Foundation grant to study the role of cuteness in designing robots. And we're looking to see how varying the cuteness level of robots impacts people's willingness to accept robots into their homes. It's really, really exciting and fun to work with students on this.
I'm not sure if you're able to share, but so far, do you see that more users are willing to engage with robots that are more cute?
Yes, that seems to be the case. And if you hold on 1 second. This is a robot called Aibo.
Oh my God, she's adorable.
And Aibo means partner, as in like if you're a police officer and you have a partner, we call her Happy.
Yeah, so what does this robot do? Tell me more about Happy.
So Happy is designed as a pet. Happy can learn, so she learns to recognize people that feed her. And then what we can do with our students is we can write programs to change Happy's behavior. And we can have her do things that might be more cute or less cute and see how people might respond to that. So one of the trains of research people are looking for is whether or not essentially robotic pets might help people recover from illness or serve as companions for people who need companionship.
버크 교수의 연구는 드포 대학교의 수많은 기회 중 하나일 뿐입니다. 열정적인 교수들의 이런 심도 있는 연구가 교수와 학생 간의 끈끈한 관계를 형성할 기회를 만들어주는데요. 이를 통해 학생들이 학업에 몰두하고 동문들이 관계를 유지하는 거죠.
How would you describe the heart and soul of DePauw University?
The heart and soul of DePauw are our relationships. So it's really the way our students interact with our faculty and staff and the way our students interact with each other. Our students, faculty, and staff learn from each other and they build relationships and bonds that last for the 4 years they're at DePauw, but for years and decades beyond that. And the relationships are really, I think, the special part of DePauw and are what help differentiate us from some other schools.
The people are really the heart of DePauw, you know, they make it what it is. Everything from the way our classes work to the way our school events work, every single cog that turns at DePauw is maintained by the people being invested in keeping, you know, a very tight-knit and a very compassionate community.
Really what excites me about DePauw is the students. We have truly amazing students. We have a wonderful community, and it's really a joy to come every day and help incoming students achieve their dream of higher education and studying abroad in the U.S.
약 300년 전 드포 대학교가 설립될 당시에는 인디애나주의 작은 시골 마을에 전국 50위 안에 드는 리버럴 아츠 대학이 생긴다는 건 꿈과도 같았는데요. 오늘날 이는 현실이 됐죠. 이것도 비범한 성공이라고 할 수 있겠네요.